On Hatteberg's People, it was roughly a year ago when the state of Kansas became the only state without an arts commission. Well, since then, with the art funding dramatically cut, artists have been voicing their concerns. Well, this weekend and all this month, an art show at City Arts features 24 female artists and is the inaugural show of the Kansas chapter of the Feminist Art Project. It's organized by artist Rachel Buller, and the show, Art Lives, reflects on the state of the arts here in Kansas.
Culture is important to everyone. Nobody wants to live in a state that has no art and culture.
Rachel Buller is an assistant professor of arts at Bethel College in North Newton, Kansas. Her work is directly with students who hope to enter the art world. Well, when the state cut the Kansas Arts Commission a year ago, she and other artists were stunned at that decision by the governor and the legislature.
People spend money to participate in cultural activities. They also spend money on other things, whether it's travel, food, lodging, that the arts are an economic generator. They bring in revenue more than just to pay for themselves.
So Rachel found other female artists who agreed to put on the Feminist Art Project, basically a show of solidarity for the arts. The show is here at Wichita City Arts. Now, some of the art is sharp in its criticism of Kansas politicians, and the artists themselves have strong views. One describes how she felt about the art situation in Kansas as she was creating her art.
And I started choosing materials that I could kind of beat up and rip apart and literally cut into, and the surfaces of my paintings became a real symbol of how this whole issue is playing out.
Arts is a business, arts is a job. And we know that, and then to have a state not recognize that as a valuable part of not just commerce, but also as the cultural contract with community, is really a blow.
And I use art as a means for letting children express themselves and through their trauma. So the idea that we're getting budget cuts from that is not only harmful to our creative process, but it's harmful to children.
Kansas has more artists per capita than any other state in the nation, which I think is remarkable. Now, a year later, I wanted to work with artists around the state and make some connections and think about how can we work together creatively to move forward in spite of this economic crisis.
At this point, no one knows for sure what the future of art funding in Kansas will be. Now, there does appear to be a softening of positions from both Governor Sam Brownback and the legislature, but so far, no funding action has been taken to restore money for the arts or an arts commission.
We're going to keep creating whether or not we have the funding there, but we hope that in time it will come back around for us.
We care a lot about Kansas. We love it. Our roots are here. In order to enjoy that, we really need to find out what's happening in the government and what's happening in our community, and I'd really like to see that happen.
Arts are very much alive in Kansas and very vibrant.